Hi dear students, welcome to the third section of Act 2, Scene 2. In the last class we had seen that Lancelot and the old Gobbo both request Bassanio to get a job for Lancelot, and Bassanio appoints Lancelot as his servant. And then we had seen Lancelot speaks about his fortune. As a palm reader, he says about the fortune that he will get. And in the same section itself, we found that Bassanio gives certain instructions to his servants as a preparation to go to Belmont. So today we will see about the final section, the third section of scene. Page number 56. Enter Graciano. Graciano, where is your master? I hope that you remember the name Graciano. Graciano is one of the friends of Bassanio. So Graciano enters and asking, where is your master? Earlier we had seen that Bassanio instructs his servant that inform or request Graciano to come to my house at once. So here Graciano is present there at Bassanio's house. Where is your master? He is inquiring about Bassanio to the servant. Then Leonardo says, yonder sir, he walks. Yonder means over there sir, he is walking there. Over there, he is walking. Graciano, Signor Bassanio, Lord Bassanio. Bassanio says, Graciano, I have a suit to you. I have got a request to you. Bassanio, you have obtained it. Means it has been already granted to you. So it is granted to you. You can ask your request. Then Graciano says, you must deny me. I must go with you to Belmont. You must not refuse me. I want to come with you to Belmont. That is the request of Graciano. And he says that, don't deny my request. I want to come with you to Belmont. And in response to that, Graciano says, why? Then you must. That means you can accompany me or you can come with me. But there are certain conditions, Bassanio says. Your request is granted. You can come with me, but there are certain conditions. And what all are the conditions here? But hear thee, Graciano. Listen to me, Graciano. Thou art too wild means you are so uncontrollable. Too wild means uncontrollable. Your behavior is so uncontrollable. The second one is too rude. That means you are so rough in character and bold of voice. You have got a loud voice. Listen, Graciano, your behavior is uncontrollable. You are so rude and rough. And the third one, your voice is so loud. Parts that becomes thee happily enough, and in such eyes as others appear no faults. Parts means the qualities, and we had seen the qualities of Graciano. What all are the qualities of Graciano? Uncontrollable behavior, rude in character, loud voice. So your qualities, the qualities which suits you, become thee means suit you. The qualities you are having or suit you. Happily enough, accepted here. All the qualities, such a kind of bad qualities, all the qualities are accepted here in Venice. In Venice it is okay. You have such a kind of qualities are okay in Venice. And in such eyes as ours, and in the eyes of us ours, in the eyes of your friends like us, appear no faults. There is no fault in the eyes of your friends. The qualities you are having are accepted in Venice. And in your friend's eyes, there is no fault with your qualities. Why? Because in Venice, all the people know Graciano. So there is no issue in Venice. Even though Graciano is having such a kind of qualities like uncontrollable behavior, rude character and the loud voice. But where they are going? They are going to Belmont. In Belmont, no one knows Graciano. So that is the thing.
here Bassanio wants to say. Here in Venice, your qualities and your bad behavior, it is okay. In front of us, your bad qualities are okay. And for your friends, there is no problem. But where thou art not known, why there they show something to liberal. But where thou art not known, that is a reference to Bellman. In the place where your qualities are not known, why there they show something to liberal. Where your bad qualities are not known, there all your qualities appear as false. So in a way, Bassanio says that your qualities are accepted in Venice, but in Belmont, we do not know whether they will accept your such a kind of behavior. So now we got an idea about the character of Graziano. And now Bassanio, he said that you can accompany with me, but you are having so and so qualities. Here it is accepted, but not in Belmont. So I pray thee, I request you, take pain to ally with some cold drops of modesty thy skipping spirit. So here Bassanio gives an instruction. He says that you have to control your behavior. When you come with me to Belmont, you have to control your behavior. Pray thee, request you, take pain, take care to ally with some. To ally means temper, with some cold drops of modesty thy skipping spirit. He says that I request you to control your wild behavior, the skipping spirit or the wild spirit or the wild behavior. With what? By putting a modest temper. By putting a modest temper, you have to control your behavior, your wild behavior or the wild spirit. You can come with me, but you have to control your behavior. Otherwise, if Graziano does not control his behavior, then what will happen? That also Bassanio says, lest through thy wild behavior I be misunderstood in the place I go to and lose my hopes. If you are not behaving properly, lest means or else, otherwise, then through your wild behavior, because of your bad behavior and bad character, I be misunderstood in the place. I will be misunderstood in the place I go. In Belmont, I will be misunderstood and lose my hopes. What is the hope here? To marry Portia. And if you are coming with me and if you are not behaving properly, then because of your wild behavior, I may lose my hopes of marrying Portia. So you have to take care about your behavior and you have to control your behavior. And now next page. So in response to that, Graziano says, Signor Bassanio, hear me. If I do not put on a sober habit, Signor Bassanio, Lord Bassanio, hear me, listen to me. If I do not, now always Graziano says certain things that he is going to do in Belmont. And the last line of the dialogue, we will understand that Graziano says that if I am not going to do the following things, then don't trust me anymore. So what all are the things Graziano guarantees to Bassanio that we will see now? If I do not put on a sober habit means a serious manner, a serious look, or the decent clothes. If I do not put a serious look or the decent clothes, then if I do not talk with the respect and swear but now and then, that means I won't swear, I won't take any kind of oath here and there without any reason. And swear but now and then means swear rarely. If I do not swear rarely, then wear prayer books in my pocket. The meaning it is given, carry. If I do not carry the prayer books in my pockets, look demurely. Demurely means in a serious manner. So I will carry the prayer book and I will have a modest look. Then he says, nay, more. Nay, more means no.
I shall speak further. I shall go further means I will do few more things when I am in Belmont. While Grace is saying, hood mine eyes, thus with my hair and sigh. He says that while the prayer before the meal is said, then I will close my eyes by placing my hat before them and say. While Grace is saying means while the prayer before a meal is said, then what he will do? He says that hood my eyes. Hood means I will close my eyes with the what? Thus with my hat. While the prayer before the meal is said, then I will close my eyes with the my hat. And that was a custom during that time. Just at the time of prayer, they close their eyes. And he says, and say Amen. I will close my eyes with a hat during the time of the prayer before the meal. And I will say Amen to the people. The word Amen means it is a concluding part of a prayer. And it means may it be so. It is the concluding part of the Christian prayers. So he says that I will close my eyes with my hat and I will say Amen in front of people. Then he continues, use all the observance of civility. What is the meaning of that? I will use all the manners of a civilized society, accepted society. I will use all the manners of civilized society like one well studied in a sad Austrian to please his grandam. It means that I will use all the manners of a civilized society, observing all manners like the one who has learned to put an appearance to please his grandmother. Grantham means grandmother. Sad Austin means serious appearance. And studied means practiced putting up or learn. So whenever we are in front of elder people or our grandmother or grandfather, our parents, we behave in a proper manner. We observe all the good manners. The same way he says that when I will be in Belmont, then I will also behave in a civilized manner, just like a person who behaves in a perfect manner in front of his grandmother or the elders. And finally he says that never trust me more. If I am not doing all these things, then don't trust me. In the starting of the dialogue itself, I said that Cassiano makes some promises and he guarantees to Bassanio something. So these all are the guarantees and the promises. And if I do not follow these guarantees or the promises, and what will be the result? Do not trust me. So I am ready to follow all the promises. I said these all are the promises. Then if I am not following that, then do not trust me anymore. What all are the guarantees or the promises here? The first one, he will put a serious look and decent clothing. And the second one, he will talk with respect. And third one, he won't take oath here and now. And then he will carry a prayer book and he will have a modest look. The fifth one, he will have a modest look and appearance. And the sixth one, when the prayer before the meal is said, then he will close his eyes with the hat and will say Amen in front of people. And the seventh one, he will observe all the manners of a civilized society, just like a person who acts or behaves in a good manner in front of his grandmother. So these all are the promises and the guarantees. And if he fails to follow these promises, then what is the result? What he says here, do not trust me. I hope that it is clear to you. Now we will see the rest. After hearing all these things, Bassanio says to Cassiano that, well, we shall see your bearing. Bearing means conduct or behavior. We will watch your behavior or your conduct. Then Cassiano says, nay, but bar tonight, you shall not gauge me by what we do tonight. Nay means no, but I bar tonight. Give me an exception today.
So I will have all the good behavior, he promised in the last dialogue. But here Graciano says, for tonight, at least for today, give me an excuse. Why? You shall not gurge me by what we do tonight. And that night, Graciano is planning to do something that we will see in the coming scenes. So because of that, Graciano says that you should not judge me what I am going to do today. So Graciano plans to do something, and for that, don't judge him. He is saying to Bassanio. No, but I should be excused tonight. Give me excuse tonight. You must not judge me by what we do tonight. And as I told earlier, he already gave the promises, and it is his duty to keep the promise. But only for that one day he asked excuse. Then what is the response from Bassanio? No, that were pity. No, it would be a pity to do that. So that means Bassanio is not having any problem with what Graciano is going to do that day. And only the condition is that he must behave well in Belmont when he accompanies Bassanio. And he continues that, I would entreat you rather to put on your boldest suit of mirth, for we have friends that purpose merriment. I would entreat, I would request you to put on your boldest suit. What is the meaning of that? Put on your happiest mood. You have to be in your happiest mood. Why? Because for we have friends to entertain. The reason, we have seen that Bassanio, the same night, he is planning a party to his friends. So that is the reason he says, you have to be in your happiest mood so that we have got many friends to entertain. And the two meanings are given regarding suit of mirth means party dress or the amusing manner or the happy mood. Both the meanings you can use, but the best one is the second one. Amusing manner or the happy mood. You have to be in a happy mood because we have got friends to entertain. Then, but fare you well, I have some business. Now goodbye, I have got some other business or other activities. Then Graciano says that I must to Lorenzo and the rest. I must go to Lorenzo and the others, but we will visit you at supper time. I will go right now to Lorenzo and other friends, but we will visit you. We will come to you at the dinner time or the party time. And that was the request from Bassani also. When you come for the party, you have to be in happy mood so that we can entertain our friends. For that, Graciano says that now I will go, but at the time of supper or the dinner, I will be back. I hope that it is clear to you. Here in this part, we had seen that Graciano requests Bassanio to take him to Belmont when Bassanio goes to Belmont. But Bassanio says that you can accompany me, but you have to control your behavior. And in response to that, Graciano says he will control his behavior. And if he is not controlling his behavior, then do not trust Graciano anymore. And then Graciano makes one day excuses, and Bassanio grants that excuse and asks Graciano to be present for the party in a happy mood. Graciano accepts that, and both of them depart or exit from the scene. The next scene we will see in the next class. I hope that it is clear, and if there is any doubts, you should ask me. Thank you. Have a nice day.